multidisciplinary panel, as we were discussing, economists are often a bit like not real social scientists, not real lawyers, so we are somewhat in between. And so I'm going to give you a couple of preliminary remarks based on my perspective as an economist. And as an economist, I mean, it's an obsession that we have. We have to define and measure things. So starting from the beginning, development for us is the improvement in living standards. So that's the idea that, of development that I've got in mind. It can be measured or observed along a monetary dimension. And in this case, we have the reduction of poverty, or development can be observed along a non-monetary dimension. In this case, we talk about improvement in health or literacy. Economic growth, instead, is what I refer to as the increase in gross domestic product. And the reason why I think it's important to start talking about development and economic growth is because one thing that we know from historical experience is that region practices can affect the attitude of people towards accumulation, inequality, education, and these are certain important drivers of economic growth. One of the most disturbing results that has been reported in the literature, and that I believe we should keep in mind, is that there is a negative effect of religious fragmentation on economic growth. The religious freedom and religion diversity in a country can be actually a positive factor on economic growth, because diversity is a way to strengthen dialogue over ideas, exchange of ideas, diffusion of different ideas, innovation for support in economics. As far as I'm concerned, and I'm coming to, the end of my remarks, I have a few ideas that, in my opinion, deserve attention and discussion in this panel. First of all, religion, what we call the inclusiveness of economic growth. Now, economic growth has a development impact to the extent that it's inclusive. By inclusive, I mean that all individuals, especially those at the bottom end of income distribution, must have access to the benefits and opportunities that are generated through growth. So, in order for growth to have really an impact on development, we need to make sure that this growth is inclusive. And here is where religious freedom, in particular, can play an important role. It can play an important role in making growth more inclusive. There is also clear evidence that religious freedom goes hand in hand with other types of freedom that have been found important for inclusive growth. I'm talking about economic freedom, I'm talking about all sorts of freedom that help individuals engage with each other and engage with the community. Finally, and that's an hypothesis that has not been tested empirically as far as I know, and that I have put forward to our host, Dr. Brian Adams, as a possible way of work where economists can work with multidisciplinary on this theme. The idea that religious freedom can impact growth and development conditional on other factors like the quality of institutions, on the type of human capital. I know it's a word that not many people like, but that's the word that we use in economics. The type of human capital that exists in a country. So, as you can see, my perspective as an economist is full of questions, probably, and full of hypotheses that deserve more discussion and more investigation, but certainly I'm very happy to be here today, because I'd love to hear perspectives from different disciplines, but I believe that there is a lot that we can discuss in a multidisciplinary sense.